Greetings, people of the internet. I've returned, and I decided that I'm going to color this. It took me a while to decide. But I have all my colored pencils, which you can't see from there, but I do have them. They exist. And I guess I have to color this one. I don't really have any skin tones, so I'll have to try and make my own. So forgive me if this is strange. But I do think that yellow works pretty well for skin tones. Like, at least as a base. I'm gonna add more colors too. I usually think that doing stuff like this ruins it for me, because I don't really color things much. But I'll give it a try. It's always good to try things that you don't know how to do, so you can get better at them. Well, I brought an eraser because I want to erase some of these pencil lines. And this also does work on the colored pencils a little bit. It makes them fade in case I overdo it a little bit. I'm going to erase everything on the face. There we go. And now I can color all of that area. I think I have quite a bit of yellow in my skin. Like here, there's a few. It's very patchy. Skin is green, pink, yellow, red, brown too, gray, purple. It's a lot of colors. So I'm gonna see if maybe if I blend a bunch of colors together, I can make a nice skin tone. She is supposed to be Asian, so I'll try to make her look like the same skin tone as most anime girls are. They're usually ranging from tan to very pale. We'll see how that goes. I guess now I have to decide what's going to be skin. All of that. Let's see. Now, is this the part of the neck? Yeah, it is. It's hard sometimes to remember which parts are skin and which parts are other things. Not sure. There we go. There we go. I feel like this part is a little bit too yellow, so I'm gonna erase the places that I think it got a little bit overhand. Okay. It doesn't have to be even. It has to be patchy, so I'm gonna randomly erase a bit. Because skin is patchy. Skin is not even. Unless you have perfectly even skin, if so, I guess it's cool. I like patches. I think they look nice. When people have stuff like that. Gonna make these areas much more bright yellow. That way, I can know that these are supposed to be shadows. It's much brighter than all the other parts. There. I think also some shading under the hair. Well, close to the hair. Here we go. Now, if only I had a sharpener. I should probably get one, shouldn't I? Well, I'll see if I do. Meanwhile, I'll darken up these places that need to be darkened. Like under the eyebrow, and a little bit under the eye. Although I don't typically see this on a lot of anime characters. They don't, unless it's like they're trying to be a bit more realistic. They don't really draw that part usually. I don't see that. I'd like to hollow out the cheekbones a little bit. Because looking at her body proportions, she's very thin. So she would definitely have that. There we go. That's nice. And a little bit closer to the hair here. Yeah, okay. That looks good. Now, let's see. Do I have a shirt? I'll find one while I draw. Okay, so I think next should be some pink. A bit of pink would make her look more like a human being. I think right now she looks a bit strange, doesn't she? Let's see. It's a little streaky, but that's fine. Skin isn't perfect. It's the most damaged organ on your body, and it's always getting replaced. Here we go. That's starting to look more like skin. She looks like she has a sunburn right now, but I'm not sure if the pink is transferring in the camera that much. Now I have to make darker the parts where I made the yellow darker. There we go. That looks nice. I don't know why her skin tone right now reminds me of mangoes. I guess it makes sense, red and yellow. They use those on a lot of candies. The colors, even though mangoes, at least the ones I've seen, are usually green and yellow. Well, green and red. I've seen green and red. And just yellow. But I have not seen red and yellow.
Maybe that's more popular in other parts of the world.
There are lots of different types of mangoes. And I like all of them. They're so good. I just came from work, you know? So I'm pretty damp from washing plates. There we go. That looks nice. What color does she need? I think brown. I don't want to make her too dark because I don't generally see a lot of anime characters that are very dark. Sadly, you know? I wish there were more. Like, I think, Chad from Bleach, he's Latino. Who else? In Death Note, there's Aizawa. I'm pretty sure he's black. There we go. Now this looks like a skin tone. I am planning after all this to erase it. So if it looks a little bit too orangey and stuff, it's fine. And also if it looks really grainy, because the eraser kind of fades that out. Which is really nice, you know? It's like a life jacket. I drew something on my board outside. Because it's my roommate's birthday today. She's at class. I'm just hoping she sees it when she comes back from class. Hopefully our neighbor doesn't erase it. He is interesting. There we go. Much nicer. Now that almost looks like actual skin. Although it does still look really, really sketchy. I suppose that's why markers are better, if you get fancy markers. There's her mouth. Darken up the neck a little bit. If it gets a little bit in the hair, it doesn't really matter. I'll go over it with another color. It's not too important. I guess I'm not that much of a perfectionist. I'm sure some people are really bothered by it. There we go. That looks like a skin tone. What else does she need? I think maybe a bit more pink would be good. But a different shade, I think. This one's a bit brighter. Just a few. So, this stopped recording for a bit, but I didn't really do much. I just erased where the highlights go, and I softly erased over the entire thing to make the skin tone look a little bit more even. And now I'm moving on to the eyes, which maybe you have seen that I I colored in the white a little bit pink. I'm not sure if it shows very well on camera. Let's see. There it is. There's pink. But that's because the whites of our eyes are not actually white. They're just lighter than everything around them, so they appear to be. I think they're like a bluish tinge for a lot of people. And I wanted to make hers be kind of purple, but I didn't want to use actual purple. So I'm using pink and blue. Very lightly. You can't tell, but in person you can see it. What color eyes should we give her? Let's see. I kind of like this green color. Pretty sure this is Olivia. Okay. So, I suppose I should start off with the base colors that I'm going to be using. So, here's a dark green. And here's the olive. And here I have black. Now, what I want to do is I want to make the eyes have some of that style that a lot of Japanese drawings have. So, I'm going to make the top part black. And I'm going to make it fade into a lighter color as it goes lower. So I'm going to feather out a little bit like that. And then I'll take the next color, dark green. And I'll start in the part where I feathered out with the black, and I'll feather it down some more. And then finally, I'll go to the olive color, and I'll fill in everything else. Doesn't her eye look really nice now? Yeah, I like that. If only I had some white paint, then I could make a really nice highlight on her. Actually, if I have some white out, that would work. I don't think I have white out. I just have snacks. Lots of snacks. That's what happens in college. But I do have some pens. And I wanted to give them a try. I haven't really used them before. So let's see how this goes. They're Pigma. They're fancy. I like them. My friend gave them to me. It's gonna be my birthday soon is all. I wanna make lines like this. Ooh, look at that. Now that gives a nice look. I like that. And the way it fades out looks really pretty too. Yeah, that's pretty. I like that. Okay. Now, if only I had some white. Now, what color should I do for the eye patch? I don't want to use any black on it. I'm going to make this gold. Gold is hard to accomplish. I don't think I can do it at such a small scale. It's a lot of browns. And leaving white space. So I think for this I'll attempt it, but I would not expect it to be very good because it's too small and I need a sharpener badly. So there you go. That's my attempt at gold right now. If I had some white gouache, that would be nice. But all I have is this, which doesn't really do much when you use it, you know? What can you do? Okay, so now I guess it's time to move on to the eye patch, which I am not looking forward to. Ooh, you know what I should do? I want to give her purple hair. Yeah, let's do that instead of the eye patch. That sounds like much more fun. So, I'm going to erase all these lines that I made for her hair. Because I did them originally not thinking that I was going to color this. But now that I'm going to color it, I don't want to go over those lines. Because, I don't know, when it just seems to be, it looks muddled when I go over pencil lines with colored pencil. That's just what happens. I'm not good at explaining things. There we go. There, now her hair is a clean slate. So we can make it purple. Now let's see. This is blue violet. I have some ocean blue. Although, I'm not sure if I'm going to be able to use it. See this? We can attempt it. I have some... Nah, that wouldn't be a nice color. I think if I use the black again, that would be fine. But this is dark brown. Where's the black? There it is. I want to use these colors for the hair. I guess I could use the olive again. I kind of like how it went with everything. It looks really nice. It was a different color than I expected it to be. I have some gray too, but I don't think I want to incorporate that. Maybe some pink? Let's make her hair now. Okay, so I want to start with the lightest color. So I'm guessing this is going to be the lightest color, or this. So, I think for her, I want to make some hair that looks like it's been dyed. I feel like that would be nice. So I'm going to first color in all the edges. Only where the sun is hitting, I think, would be a good idea. So, right here, I didn't color that in because I think this hair would provide a little bit of shadow. There we go. I think this wouldn't get a lot of sunlight because it's in the back. And I'm imagining the sun is, like, pointing from here. Okay, now let's do olive. Ooh, I see. I like this. Maybe you guys don't like this, but I think this is nice. Reminds me of kiwis. Kiwi strawberry. I'm going to put it in the middle. There we go. I like that. Okay. Now let's see this purple. I kind of want to blend these. Blend the pink and the red purple together. I wonder if I should... Oh, I have an idea. Let's see. I think I should make this side purple and this side blue. Would that be nice? I think that'd be nice. And then make the back black. Okay, so I should make the black first so I don't forget about it. And I'm doing the same thing that I did with the eyes. I'm starting off really dark and then fading it out. I think I'll put a little bit here, but not much. I don't think it needs it. There we go. I want this part to be the darkest part of the entire drawing. Well, of her hair. There. Okay. Now, purple. I want purple and blue to be the primary colors, and the green and pink to just be highlights. So I'm going to draw over them a little bit with the purple and the blue. So let's see how that works out. There we go. I like that. Okay. Now, I don't want to make these be that colored. I would think she only put highlights, green and pink highlights, on the front of her hair, near her face. Because, yes, that's why she did that. She did it because of yes. Okay, I think that's enough purple. Now the blue. Let's see if the blue even works. Oh, it does! Oh my god, that is very bright. Well then. Did not expect that. It doesn't look that bright, does it? Now she looks like a unicorn. I saw some... There's unicorn Starbucks things. I'd like to try one. The promotion ends on my birthday, so I'll probably try some before then. Wow, look at that. Is that not great? Oh, I love that. Maybe some on this side, too. Just put a little bit of blue in there. On top of the green. And down here, too. Wow. That is shocking. I like that. I just like the blue. Let's put blue everywhere. Okay. I'm glad I made the decision to make the blue be the color that's going to be on the biggest part of the hair. Because this looks really nice. I like it. Oh, but it's not going to have the same rainbow effect that the hair had before. So I guess I should continue with purple a little bit. Even though it's not very nice to work with this purple, it is causing difficulty. That's my fault, though. If I had a sharpener, the life of a college student. There we go. That's what I want. Okay. Why does this draw better than this? It's funny. Now let's continue. Oh, this blue is so pretty. She has rainbow hair now. That's nice. I did not know we were going to do this. As you can probably tell, I did not plan any of this. I just had some time. I think I mentioned already that it's my roommate's birthday today. And I made her a drawing outside. Maybe I'll show you guys after I finish this drawing. Ooh, that blue and green mix looks nice when it touches the edge of the green. Okay. So her hair seems to be primarily blue, and I'm okay with that. It's a nice color. Oh, it's not my favorite color. And this tip right here. There we go. So that's her hair. She's cute. I think that's all I'm going to do today. And maybe next time we can draw the outfit. I'm not sure what I'm gonna do for it. I'll do my best. Oh, I guess I should show you guys what I drew for my roommate. Let's see. Here it is. It's her walking in on her roommates turned into cats and playing with her things. I think it's pretty funny. So yeah. Okay, so you guys will let me know if you have any ideas for the clothes, and hopefully I can not forget to do the eyebrows next time. Okay, well, yeah, I'm so sorry. Anyone who noticed that is probably so annoyed with me. There we go. Good eyebrows. Well... see you, people of the internet, next time. Bye.